we are doing here tonight was illegal from 1855 until the potlatch laws ended in 1951. You see, the potlatch system of giving away your wealth to your guests was in direct conflict with the ideals of capitalism. Under capitalism, people gain respect by accumulating possessions. A couple houses, or a couple cars, a nice house and a boat, people think you're doing pretty well. Under the potlatch system, you gave away your possessions to your guests, and that's how you gained status and honor. And the government of the day didn't like that. So this is no potlatch that we're doing tonight. Unfortunately, I don't have gifts for everybody. But the laws were interpreted very loosely in the day. And what it meant in practice was that groups of Indians could not gather to dance, sing, or celebrate. Had telephones been more prolific in 1885, I'm sure the government would have set up a hotline for our neighbors to report our barbaric cultural practices. Does that sound familiar to anybody? And so you guys being here tonight gives me hope. It gives me hope that Canada and Canadians are better than the racist politics that we've seen during this election campaign. And it gives me hope that on Monday we'll be able to get Canada back on track again. Thank you. Chief Maureen Chapman became the hereditary chief of Skowal First Nation in 1999. She works tirelessly for her community members, and the genuine care that she has for First Nations issues is clearly illustrated by the fact that she is politically active as a member of Stalo Nation's Chiefs Council, First Nations Health Council, Union of BC Indian Chiefs, the BC Assembly of First Nations, and the First Nations Summit. Wow, you're very busy. So, ladies and gentlemen, Chief Maureen Chapman.
Thank you, Mike, and it's my pleasure to welcome each and every one of you here tonight, second annual. And Mike always talks about being so nervous. He does a stellar job. I mean, he does an amazing job.